If there's one thing that popular culture has gotten right, it's that pretty soon most of us will have relationships with robots.
In fact, you probably already have some basic relationships with machines. When I say relationships, you might think of romantic relationships, but the hype around sex robots is just that, hype. That's not gonna be a thing for a while. And anyway, most relationships aren't sexy, but they're still important. And robots may very well be a part of the most important relationships in your life.
Welcome to Uprising. Fear not. The robots are already here.
Ebony.
The first met with Buddy, the interaction was completely different. There was that emotional things, the cute pace, and the fact that touching him and directly you have a reaction and a connection. As you probably noticed, I'm not seeing it, I'm seeing him.
Okay, Buddy, suis-moi.
That surprised me a lot. Even if it's a robot, it's only circuits and motors. There is that connection.
Je vais bien, merci. J'espère que vous passez une agréable journée.
Sometimes he's sad, sometimes he's happy, sometimes he will come to see you and just dance just near you. He has his own life, so it's quite interesting.
Yes, tell me more.
Buddy is an emotional robot being developed by Blue Frog Robotics in Paris. He's meant to be a companion bot, a member of the family.
People really see Buddy like a character. It's not just an artificial intelligence like Amazon Echo able to answer to all your questions. It's not the key point. For us, the key point is to simulate the life. The idea is to have a robot able to provide useful services all the day for each member of the family. Buddy can secure your home, we can connect to the robot and see. You can also play with children, you can play a hide and seek or red light, green light.
A robot that you could have near you, we will help you in your day-to-day life, just to put the light on, the music on, and still having that emotional connection and keeping people happy around you as well.
Buddy is an emotional robot in that he expresses emotions. He can look sad or angry or scared, but he's just a robot. He doesn't really feel anything. So it would be easy to say these are fake emotions, but that's oversimplifying things too.
If I put my finger in your eyes, it won't be very nice for you. And it's the same thing with a robot. He feels something, he will react, and we do the same. So maybe we're also a big computer, so I don't know where is the difference, the real difference.
But even if we assume that Buddy's emotions aren't real, our emotions are. And that's all it takes for a relationship to be real.
If you ask people to drop Buddy from a table, they say, I won't do that. I will hurt him, not it, you know.
So the emotional part is for sure something that you bring. After a year of interaction now, I see Buddy like a teenager, a part of my family or my circle of friends, but growing up and able to have more and more ability in the future.
Right now, Buddy is still in beta testing. But once he's ready for consumers, he won't just be a toy. One of his most important roles will be helping us take care of our elders. In many countries, people are starting to live longer and have fewer children. That means there's a greater demand for elder care and fewer young people to provide it. A robot like Buddy can help fill that gap.
Buddy can be seen like a nice and cute gadget, but for elders' needs, there is a real added value to have a robot like Buddy. And if you have a robot like Buddy, you can stay at home longer in good conditions. It can monitor their activity to be sure that everything is okay. It can entertain them and just to be a presence for them.
You take the control of Buddy, you go in the kitchen, how are you today? And as you see them, it's enough to see if everything is fine. So it's important, I think, for old people to have such support.
Over the last few hundred years, society's structure has changed dramatically. What was once focused on the family unit is now focused on the individual. More people move far away from their parents. Robots like Buddy can help us reconnect our communities, help us support older people as they age and remain in their homes. The relationships we have with machines are only going to get more common and more complex, especially as they allow us to expand and rediscover our relationships with other humans.
Why do cows have bells? Because their horns don't work.
Thanks for watching this episode of Uprising. Please like and subscribe. It really helps us grow our channel and tell more stories about people who are thinking differently and changing the world.